us now how we can take care of the situation for Wheatstone bridge in capacitors. Okay, so draw this Wheatstone bridge of capacitor. Let us say this is C1, C2, C3, C4 and C5. Now when C5 will become useless, or when the capacity that doesn't matter for this capacitor, when there is no charge on it, right? Okay, so it's like a bucket which has no base in it, so when you pour water it just goes out, so it can't store anything. So this capacitor, even though you know it is defined, it has capacity C5, but if it is balanced and potential difference between these two points is zero, then this capacitor will not store any charge. So effectively capacity of this capacitor is nothing. So I can just throw it away. If I throw it away, these two become series, these two become series, and the upper one and lower one become parallel, right? So when that can happen, when potential of this point is equal to potential of that point. Fine. Now can you get a relation among C1, C2, C3, C4 for that to happen?
Sir, can you use touch of neutral for capacitors also?
Yeah, you can do that. As long as it is a loop. Should I do it? Should I do it? You got it? Okay. So assume if this plate has plus Q charge, how much charge this plate will have? No. This plate number 1, plate number 2 and plate number 3, are these isolated system? So some of the charges should be zero. This plate has no charge, so this will have minus Q, this will have plus Q, this is minus Q. Okay, let's say this is Q1, so this is Q1, and suppose here this one has plus Q2 charge. Okay, this, stop talking, this is minus Q2, this will have what charge?
Plus Q2,
and this is minus Q2. Fine. Now this is one loop and this is other loop. Can you write down Kirchhoff's loop rule equation for these two? So I am going from A to, let us say, C. So how much is the potential difference? Q by C? Minus Q1 by C or plus Q1 by C?
Charge is positive, negative will be negative.
I am decreasing my potential, right? I am going from positive charge to negative charge. So it will be minus Q1 by C2. Okay? Then I am going across this. Again I am decreasing my potential. So minus Q2 by C1 is equal to 0. Any doubt on this? Doubt that? No doubt. Q1 by C2 is equal to Q2 by C1 minus of that. This is your first equation. Now in second loop, let's go from A to this point D. It will be plus Q1 by C3 or minus Q1 by C3?
Plus
Q1. Plus Q1 by C3. Then from D to B, it's again plus. Plus Q2 by C4 is equal to 0. So Q1 by C3 is equal to minus of Q2 by C4. This is the second equation. Fine. Now when you divide these two equations, you will get C3 by C2 is equal to C4 by C1. Okay. So again, this is a very similar looking expression. C3 by C2 is equal to C4 by C1. When that happens, this capacitor, you can just throw it away, because it has no meaning. It doesn't store any charge. Okay? Okay, do this. You have a cube like this. Find out equivalent resistance between A and B. Each branch has a resistance of R. You understood what is happening here?
Each edge has R.
Each edge has resistance R. There are 12 edges. Okay? Find the equivalent resistance between A and B. Fine. Are you able to solve this? Do you see any series of parallel combination here? No, there is nothing. Okay? But you see lot of symmetry here. Okay? So if I connect a battery like this, and if I somehow know this current I in terms of V, then I can say V by I is equivalent resistance or not? Right? So R equivalent should be equal to V by I, but then I don't know I. Okay? So I have to find I somehow. Getting it? Now, the thing here is that you have to use symmetry. For example, when I comes over like this, what is the current here? Can you guess?
I by 3.
It will equally split because of symmetry. It will split equally. Okay? What about here?
I by 6.
This is I by 6. By 6. Fine. Then this one becomes I by 3. I by 6 from here and I by 6 from there. I by 3. So this becomes I by 3, I by 6, I by 6. And this one also becomes I by 3. Fine. Okay. Are you getting it? Okay. Now apply Kirchhoff's loop rule in this loop. This one. The external one. See what you get. So the equation will be what? When you go from here to here, what will come? Plus V or minus V?
Plus V.
Plus V. And then from here to here, what it will be? Minus I by 3 times R. Resistance of this branch is R. Everywhere it is R. What about this? Minus I by 6 times R. Then again, minus I by 3 times R is equal to 0. Okay? So I will get what? V is equal to 2 by 3 IR plus IR by 6. So V is equal to 6 5 IR. So V by I is 5 R by 6. So equivalent resistance is 5 R by 6. Okay? Looking uncomfortable. Fine? Okay? So you may not need to use those standard ways of finding equivalent resistance. You can make use of symmetry also at times.
Where are we using the loop?
This one. Okay? Let's do one or two more questions like this. You're showing some question, right? Brothers, Everywhere resistance is R. You need to find equivalent resistance between this point and that. Do you see any line of symmetry or plane of symmetry?
Yes.
So whatever happens above, similar thing should happen below. Let us say you connect a battery. Of V. Current I starts to flow. How much current will go here? I by 3. Here also it should be I by 3 and I by 3. Fine. So I by 3 comes from here and goes in that direction. Nothing goes in these two and these two. What I am saying is I by 3 splits like this. From here it is symmetrical. From here also it is symmetrical. So I by 3 should reach from all three directions. Getting it?
Yeah.
Fine. So I can now use Kirchhoff's loop rule in this. So I can write down V minus I by 3 R minus I by 3 R is equal to 0. So V is equal to 2 R by 3 times I, or V by I is 2 R by 3. Okay.
I will go through.
No, current is there. I'm not saying current is not there. I'm saying this current, here it is I by 3 and here also I by 3. Fine. So from here, no current is going from this side. Current might reach from there.
Yeah, but when it comes here,
all the current goes there. Whatever comes here, go like that. So as if it is not connected, it doesn't matter. It is like this. Okay, this is one way of solving, or you can actually find out different resistance. These two are in series, then parallel with this, these two series parallel with this, then you will do all that, you will get the same answer, 2 R by 3. Just try it out. No, but it says answer is not that.
Is it 5 R by 3?
No.
What is 6 R by 7?
4 R by 3. It says. But what is wrong in this V minus I?
Sir, we didn't consider.
Sir, we didn't know.
Oh, there is one error we have done. See, these two directions are same, but this is not same as these two. Are you getting it? So this I will split like this. I will go like that. This is I1, this is I2, then this is also I2. Because these two are equal. This is not equivalent to these two. Fine. So this is I1 only. And this is I2, and that is I2. Fine. And I is what?
I1 plus I2.
I is I1 plus 2I2. Fine. So let us try to. This R, and this R.
The points are not connected,
it doesn't matter. See, the thing is, this same current is here, na?
Uh-huh.
So I told you already. So let us try to write Kirchhoff's equation for this loop. So I can write down V minus I1R minus I1 times R is equal to 0. This is the first equation. Okay. Now, in order to get I2, I can see that these two, this is 2R. 2R parallel with R becomes how much? 2R with R divided by, so this is 2R by 3. Okay. So this one is 2R by 3. This is 2R by 3. Now for I2 also I can solve, I can write down Kirchhoff's equation for this loop. So this will be V minus I2R minus I2 into 2R by 3 minus I2R is equal to 0. Any doubt on this?
Sir,
any doubt on this? Okay. So I have written Kirchhoff's equation for this particular loop. V minus I2R minus I2 into 2R by 3 minus I2 times R is equal to 0. So now I will try to find out I1 and I2 from these. Okay. So I1 is what? I1 is V divided by 2R. Fine. What is I2? V minus 2I2R minus 2R by 3 I2 is equal to 0. So V minus 3 to the 6, this is 8 to R by 3 is equal to 0. So I2 will be equal to 3V by 8R. Fine. So total current will be what? Total current will be V by 2R, which is I1, into 2 times I2. So that is 3V by 4R. Okay? Fine. So this will be I is equal to 4R 2V plus 3V. Okay? So V by I is equal to 4R by 5. Fine? Any doubt on this? So this is slightly different way of solving it. You could have solved it in an easier way. What you could have done is here also this resistance would have been 2R by 3. Now this resistance, this and this, they are in series, 2R and 2R by 3. This is what? R plus R. This is 2R by 3, R and R. So like that, you have parallel combination after that. You will get the same answer. Okay? Since we have used this method earlier, so I am trying to use the same method and you know, explain you that you can do like that also this question.
So similarly, we can solve capacitor questions using this method.
Symmetry can be used anywhere. Doesn't matter the physics, chemistry, mathematics, it doesn't matter.
What?
This current will be same as that current, has to be. So this current is not splitting here. Whatever current is coming here, it goes like this. Okay, so other questions, please practice yourself first and then we can discuss that next class.